Next point I want to make very clear, the Quran keeps telling all the time that the blessing of the book, the barakah of the book, the benefit of the book actually is connected with understanding and thinking. What we Muslims do very often, that you know, if we really want to know the Quran, we listen to those people, you know, who can make us, you know, make our heart to move. To, you know, somebody, you know, comes and gives a sermon and preaching, and you know, he mentions things in a way that we become really amazed, and you know, our heart is moved. And then after that, we come home and we think, and sometimes people just cry, and the tears come from your eye, and we think we have done the thing. This is not actually why the Quran has come. Quran did not come to move the heart of the people. Quran really did not come to make the tears come from the eye of the people. So then why Quran has come? Quran has come to make you to understand and think properly. Quran has come to you that you change the, your life according to the Quran. So that's why when you read the Quran, the first thing it should be to understand the message and the meaning of the Quran properly. It is not that your heart is moved. Once you understand the meaning and message properly, then after that, certainly, no doubt really, you change your life, your heart is changed, and also your, you know, no doubt you also can see that your heart is moved. That will happen. But first thing is, understand the Quran properly. You know, whenever you read a word in the Quran, make effort that, you know, this word, you know, the meaning that I get from this word is same meaning which was understood by the Prophet ﷺ and his companions. When I read a verse, you know, try to understand properly that how the Prophet ﷺ and his companions received this verse, what they understood from that. And then after that, no doubt, certainly, you have to apply the verse to your own context. Context is changed, no doubt. But first thing is to understand what they understood. Because the Prophet ﷺ is the one who received the Quran. It is really very, very important. Why I'm saying this? Because in our time, you know, preaching has become so popular. Everybody preaches. And the people are using, you know, YouTube and this and that message. And you are in your bedroom and you can listen. And sometimes you can see really, oh, this person, you know. Many people ask them why you listen to certain people. There's a reason is because it is so eloquent and so nice and really makes my heart to move. So this is not right attitude, really. Always make effort to try to understand the Quran. Quran is not a poetry. Quran really is a message. The people have to understand properly what Quran really means, what trying to, whether you know your heart is moved or is not moved, it is not important. It is not real. Real thing is what? That you try to understand what Quran says. Even if it makes effort, even if you have to force yourself, it is a serious book. It is not a poetry. You know, it is possible, it could have been possible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reveal the Quran as poetry. So when people read and, you know, just they moved. But that's not the purpose. The purpose of the Quran that you understand and follow certain guidance. So whether your heart is moved or not moved, that is not important. Whether you are amazed by the Quran or not, it is not important. Whether you are impressed, it is not important. Quran is not revealed to impress you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no interest to impress you. Allah SWT did not reveal the Quran to you become amazed. No. Allah only revealed Quran to you that you make effort to understand it and to follow it. Simple thing really. Then after understanding and following, if you are impressed, if you are moved and amazed, that's another matter. But the main thing is follow the guidance properly. Try to understand and follow the guidance properly. So this is important. This book really has come to guide you. Sometimes people think really that I should listen to someone who can make me to follow the Quran. So this is not the book of magic. You know, there are something which Allah has to do and something His slaves have to do. You can't expect Allah to do everything. So for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, because you want to, you know, you can't survive in this world only by eating and drinking. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to do something. What? To create you in a way so then you can eat and drink. So He has to make for you the teeth, the tongue, the stomach. And also he has to make in you, you know, attraction to the food. You can eat the food and then you can digest the food. This He has to make. Allah has made all this properly. You have got teeth, you can chew the food, you can, you know, digest the food, you know, stomach is there and food is there. Then after that, He also explains to you what is beneficial for you, what is bad, what is good food for you, what is harmful for you. He also explains, He gave you mind, think. Then after that, whether you're going to eat or not, it is you have to do. Don't make Allah to come and feed you. No, He has done all that. He wants you to move. You have to find your food. You have to work hard because He put the desire in you. You can see you have desire for the food and you can digest the food. You can chew the food. Now you have to find the food. It is everywhere spread. You have to go and fight, make effort, earn the food, and then after eat it. You can't just sitting around that Allah has come to feed you. Because Allah is so merciful. He is merciful, that's why He actually made arrangement or disarrangement. What you need to do, you have to do. Simple thing, understand properly. Allah is Rabb. So He has made every single arrangement that He has done properly, no doubt really, that He made you in a way that you can eat food, you can chew the food, you can digest the food, and the food can, and He had made system of your body, you can get energy from the food. This system He has made so perfect, nobody can doubt. But you have to benefit from the system. You have to work hard. You have to do this. Now He is not going to. When you are not able, like you are in the womb of your mother, then He did it for you. When you are born, you cannot move, then He made your mother and your parent, your family to help you. But once you grown up, now you have to do. Even your mother will not do. Your mother cannot keep feeding you all your life. She also expects you that when you become 5 year old, 6 year old, you do something. Because now you are, you know, you can understand, think. Similarly, guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has what he did proper arrangement for you. He gave you mind, you know, thinking, understand properly. Then He sent the guidance and He made your mind aware that you can actually follow the guidance, understand, you can receive the command from Him. You know, really amazing thing, just think that, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you and you receive the command, understand. It is really amazing thing. For example, if you cannot command to the trees and to the stone, they can't receive the command. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the human being, He made this thing. The day He created them, He made them to receive the command, the man and woman both. You know, He said to Adam alayhi salam and his wife Eve, لا تقربا هذه الشجرة, don't come near to this tree. And eat anything, but don't come near to this tree. Adam and his wife Eve, both could receive the command of Allah. Now this thing that they have to obey, they have to do. Because Allah is master, He can command. But doing it, obedience and slavery, you have to do. And Adam and Hawa, they failed. They did not receive the command, so then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, no doubt, He has to, you know, explain to them, and you know, certain things has come in the Quran, which I am going to explain later on. But I'm trying to say, there are something Allah has to do, and there's something we have to do. Allah has done whatever He has to do. Now we people have to do, you know, whatever He has commanded us. This guidance there. To think really that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will create a certain system and we suddenly become followers of the Quran is not going to happen. We have to, that's why He addresses the people. That's why He said the messengers. Book, people have to receive the book. You know, it is, some people will say the story that, you know, somebody pious person and somebody came to his house and he ate his leftover and he became pious. So this never happens. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never going to do. What He does actually is He explains to you, you have to understand and follow properly. Force yourself to understand. No doubt. People don't like, you know, like for example, this is the weekend, you know, who wants to come in this Quranic class and to make understand things? Nobody wants to come. Because, you know, outside the life is so enjoyment. You can go walk in. Here you have to think. Here you have to understand. But Allah, the way is, all the precious things, they only come to you when you make effort. You have to force yourself. You have to make sacrifice. You have to sacrifice your enjoyment, then you get it. So this is actually very important to understand.